Offseason, NBA basketball is back. Doris, two of the best words in hoops. Opening night.
I've been waiting for tonight for months, BA. The start of a long, incredible journey that is the NBA season. We know there will be twists and turns. Tonight won't make a season, but boy, it's good to be back.
So here's Dallas's starting group. They've got Reggie Bullock, Maxi Kleber out there with Dwight Powell. Then it's Luka Doncic, and it's Irving in at the shooting guard position. Doncic on the wing. From outside the arc, fires in the triple.
Now, Luka Doncic is not shy. He trusts his range shooting, and you can see why.
Washington outside. Back to Smith. There's the three. And it's Irving with a rebound. Pass to Doncic. We played just over a minute here in the first. And they doubled up Doncic. Irving for three. Offensive rebound, Mavericks. Doncic with the bucket. Doncic has got five now.
Well, here is a player with great size and great instincts. It allows Luka Doncic to rebound consistently. Nicely done there.
And Hayward, here we go. Good D by Doncic. The Mavericks have gone 2 of 3 from the floor. Pass to Bullock. Lets it go from deep. And that's good. His first bucket of the game.
Boy, there is an artistry and a feel to Luka Doncic's game. This guy is elite with his playmaking.
Hayward's shot is off, and it's the Mavericks' ball. It's been 8 unanswered for them. Kleber passes to Irving. Powell, a screen on Smith. Here's Irving. Here's Powell. And that one's good. A nice job on the glass as they picked up 2 on the second effort.
You have to love the intensity that Powell plays with on the glass, using that long body to track down those offensive boards.
Now a timeout called by Charlotte. Let's see how last year's top scorers stack up on the 2K leaderboard. Third is Luka Doncic.
This is a guy who never took a night off. You look at his numbers and you know that he put in a tremendous effort every single game.
To Mykhailiuk. Now Smith. To stop the run. Connects from downtown.
Well, Dennis Smith Jr. showing you, yeah, the catch and shoot, I've got that too.
It's clear Charlotte has the pieces in place to make noise in the league for years to come.
Yeah, no question, BA. They got one of the best young rosters in the NBA. And they're balanced. They play tremendous team basketball. Fun to watch.
Smith passes to Hayward. Picked by Smith. Hayward with it. Guarded by Kleba. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Dwight Powell. That's his first foul. Washington passes to Smith. Hayward for three.
Yet another miss. Just one for five. Not exactly an ideal start.
Kleba outside. The three is up. Doncic, no good. The Hornets have gone 1 of 5 to start things off. Washington with the ball. Turned in an outstanding game against Dallas. Yep, that one goes.
Making a statement here early, going right to the rack. Oh, I love it.
And this is why you get the ball into his hands. Let him establish the pace and rhythm of the game.
Kleba outside from 12 feet. Pass to Bullock, Irving with it. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Back to Bullock. Lays it up and banks it in. Bullock's got 5 now.
Already 6 of their points coming off second chances. Pretty impressive.
Here's Richards. Hayward with it from behind the arc. Oh, and that miss makes him 0 for 4. Not a great start. Doncic outside. Pass to Kleba. The shot no good. And Charlotte going the other way now. Washington with the ball. Guarded by Kleba. Washington passes to Smith. Washington against Kleba. Back to Smith. Charlotte needs to get one up in a hurry. The shot by Mikhailuk, no good. Here are the Mavericks now with the ball. They're on a 15-5 run. To the inside. Parked it down low that time. Got hit with the 3-second call. All right, a quick look now at how the point totals have looked over the last few months for Gordon Hayward.
He's been on a tear offensively these past few months, and you know how much they love the extra points he provides. He's been shouldering a bigger load recently, and I think he's just getting started.
Pass to Mikhailuk. Here's Richards. Powell covers. A nice shot by Richards.
Boy, that's as wide open as you're going to get. The defense needs to lock in and be better than that.
Left side Irving. Inside. And out of bounds. Charlotte will have it. The Hornets have gone only 3 for 9 from the floor. Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
Pass to Washington from the arc. Bullock puts it in. Dallas has gone 3 for 5 from deep so far in this matchup. Now Irving. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. And there's the call on Dennis Smith. That's his first foul of the game. Here's Irving. His last outing, he had 18 points. Dallas, no good that time either.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. He just missed it.
Doncic against Smith. Back to Washington. Pass to Richards. Smith outside. Just 5 on the clock. Up and over Doncic. Smith no good.
And this is a shot he can definitely make, and the defense not a factor at all.
Now here's Irving. Back to Bullock. And it's Gordon Hayward with the foul. That's his first foul of the game. And Dallas calls time here. And we know that last year the Mavs had an issue with rim protection doors.
They did. And obviously that is the starting point, BA, for a lot of defenses. So you understand you have to address that. What you know, though, unequivocally, is you have excellent wing defenders on the roster. It's one of the most critical aspects of success in today's NBA. So really it's about solidifying the paint, and let's see where this team goes from there.
Christian Wood is checked in for Dallas. Green comes in for Bullock. Outside Irving. Clock at six. Green finds Powell.
And there's just one foul now away from the penalty.
Williams is checked in for Charlotte. Four comes in for Washington. And here is Irving. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Five on the clock. The three from Wood. Knocks it down from distance. And the Mavericks lead by 11.
It's impossible to win when you give up second and third chances to score.
Pass to Maladon. There's the drive. It's stolen by Irving. And a fast break now. The Mavericks on the run. That one goes in.
Yeah, their aggressive approach on the offensive glass has created second chance opportunities.
Here's Maladon. Pass to McGowan's. 4-3. Rebounded by Green. The Mavericks have gone 8 for 14 from the floor. Outside Irving. Back to Doncic. Basket is good. Nice setup from Irving. Irving's got three assists tonight.
Defensively, their effort hasn't been great early on.
Out left to the wing. Pass to McGowan's. Over Wood. McGowan's no good. Dallas has gone 4 of 7 from three-point range here in the first. Wood passes to Doncic. Another three for Dallas.
And the defense is really allowing them too much room on the perimeter.
Now a timeout called by Charlotte. And the Mavericks with some changes. Hardy comes in. For Kyrie Irving, and it's Ntilikina in for Luka Doncic. Charlotte is shooting 23%. Not great so far. Out to the wing. Outside, Williams. Pass to Maladon. Williams with the screen. And once again, off the mark by Charlotte.
He is too good a shooter, guys, to be left open like that. The defense just dodged a bullet there.
Wood outside. Knocked loose. Here's McGowan's. What, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. To the left wing. And there's the screen. Six to shoot. Over to the wing. Maladon for three. Gets his second attempt to go. Now he's 1 for 2. And a chance to add to the lead here.
Yeah, BA, they should really stick with what they've been doing.
Pass to Ntilikina. He tries for three. Hornets with the rebound. Last time they met was in Dallas, where they beat the Mavericks.
Yeah, they hit the court last game with some serious attitude, especially on offense.
And what surprised me was how easy they made it look. It seemed like they got something out of every possession.
Here's McGowan's. Five to shoot. Williams with the screen. Takes the three. McGowan's no good. Well, the Mavericks shooting at around 59%. Their offense is clicking right now. Wood outside. The three. Drills it from deep. Wood's gotten his second bucket on the night.
Their ball movement on this run has been tremendous. It's led to a lot of good, clean, open looks.
It's Mikhailuk on the wing. Green covering. Here's Maladon. Back to Mikhailuk. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
Both teams are starting to find a rhythm here.
And this is partly what the game has become, right? A matter of dueling three-point opportunities.
Here's Wood. And they're going to count that bucket, and they'll send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
And they're really attacking the paint with a fury.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Mavericks.
Well, they found a groove, and it's from distance, so knocking them down from the three-point land never hurts.
They've also done a great job finding openings and exploiting them. Take those lanes when they're given and turn them into points.
And the Hornets making a change here. Booknight's checked in.
Guys, when the conversation is about the Charlotte Hornets, obviously there is a figure that looms large, and that's the majority owner, Michael Jordan, the man who has six NBA titles, the man who many consider the greatest player to ever play the game.
No question who's in control of the board so far.
Pass to Ntilikina. Here's Hardy. Jacks up a three. Here's Wood, and Wood with the stuff.
They've been very effective so far. A balanced attack at its best.
On the offensive end, it feels like they're getting the shots they want, and defensively, they are connected and on a string.
They set the pick. Here's McGowan's. The bank shot, no good.
Boy, defense nowhere to be found, and neither was his shot at that time.
Pass to Hardy. Fires for three. Oh, he beats the buzzer just in time. Wow.
Big time bucket, I'll tell you. Great clock management there.
Coaches talk about ending quarters. Well, you cannot do it better than that.
And so it's Dallas with plenty of breathing room. 23 points to end the quarter. And their three-point shooting, a big reason they have a sizable lead. We're coming right back. Don't go anywhere. On the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And quite a position here for the Mavericks to be in. What do you think, guys?
Well, they've really been racking up three-pointers in bunches. They've been so impressive to watch.
And that's what has them ahead in this game. Their floor spacing has been just tremendous.
Dallas has gotten 7 of 12 three-point attempts to fall. On the court right now for Dallas, they've got Kyrie Irving, Maxi Kleba out there with Reggie Bullock. Then there's Christian Wood, and it's Doncic in at the point guard position.
Well, you can tell the team feeding off Luka Doncic right now. They see him produce. They're just getting him the basketball.
Pass to Hayward from deep. He buries it from three. Hayward's got his first 3 points of the game.
This guy is a pick-your-poison kind of player. Very hard defensively to cover all your bases with him.
From deep, here's Doncic. Basket is good. Nice setup from Irving.
This guy is cooking right now. He is leading them on the offensive end as they remain in front here.
Down low. Kleba with a steal. Gives us a chance to catch up with Allie LaForce.
Thanks a lot, Brian. Well, Luka Doncic, an all-star from his second season, and every year he's one of the favorites for MVP. But Luka says, quote, "I still haven't won anything, so I've got a long way to go." Brian, if you didn't catch it, team success is the metric. He says the key is to win a championship.
Well, he certainly gives him a chance to do just that, Allie. Thank you. Here's Bouknight. He's guarded by Irving and stolen by Wood. Pass to Doncic. Over Smith. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
Well, the hoop and the harm, Luka Doncic, the finish, and he'll get an opportunity to add to that. We have learned in a very brief period of time that there is absolutely nothing on a basketball court that Luka Doncic can't do. He is no doubt amongst the very big-time superstars in this league.
Mikhailuk's checked in for Bouknight. And how about Luka Doncic? I mean, how remarkable, Doris.
B.A., his numbers are insane when you consider how young he is. In his career, averaging more than 25 points, over 8 boards, and over 7 assists. Not many players contribute in every aspect of the game like Luka. It would seem to me, with P.J. Washington, basketball was ingrained in his DNA. Why? Each of his parents, guys, played Division I basketball.
Mind the lanes. One shot.
And that one falls for Washington. All right, Doris, how has it helped PJ Washington growing up in a basketball family?
Well, I think if you have two college players, two high-level college players, it automatically means you've got two high-level coaches who can help develop your skills at a young age. But the other part of this, the mental aspect, such a huge advantage to have people who've been there and done that.
And you look at the intangibles of Luka Doncic. He has some of the best court awareness in the league, and that shows up most with his passing and body control.
That's good from Doncic. And the way Doncic can feel the defenders around him speaks to his great court sense, Graham.
No question. And the elite footwork he has makes the most of it. I mean, one of the best at shielding defenders with his body. It's really how he can navigate through a defense with ease. They've shown the power inside. Their rebounding effort has been sensational.
Outside Irving. Lets the three fly. Kleba with a screen. From 13, fires the three. Hornets with the rebound. It's a quick turnaround on the road. Just one game. Here's Washington. That's in. Coming off an assist from Hayward. Washington's got 7 points in the game.
What nice work to get the high percentage look, and he doesn't make any mistake with it.
Irving, the pass to Doncic. Back to Irving. The three. Gets it to go. Makes him 2 for 5.
The assist numbers certainly stand out. They've really emphasized ball movement here today.
Now a timeout called by Charlotte. With a break here, let's see which teams racked up the assists during last year's campaign. Number one, the Hornets.
It was a joy to watch these guys play. Constant ball movement and player movement. Defenses were worn out by the end of games.
And now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter here. Smith against Doncic. And Washington with the basket on the assist by Smith. Washington's got 9 points.
Boy, it's passes like that one that make you want to run the offense through Smith Jr. Skill set has never been in question.
Smith against Doncic. Irving for three. And no good. And Charlotte going the other way now.
Well, it hasn't been the most efficient game for this guy, but their team is fortunate to still be out in front.
Back to Doncic. Doncic is doubled. Pass to Bullock. Irving for three. And he misses the shot again. Only 2 of 7 in this one. Smith against Doncic. Hayward outside. Back to Smith. Shot clock at 5. Uses the glass on the layup. 5 points in the game.
Boy, you have to absorb the bump on the jump shot, and Dennis Smith Jr. still able to deliver. That is not easy, folks.
Wood finds Doncic. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. It goes on Dennis Smith. You know, for most players, being a starter has value. But Grant, some elite teams have been elevated by great players who have accepted a reserve role.
And it's really special, BA, when you have that. Players who are willing to sacrifice for the greater good of the team. Putting winning first at all costs. And you think about it, through the years, Manu Ginobili with the Spurs, Andre Iguodala in Golden State, it really can galvanize a team and lead to winning championships.
First free throw is good.
Boy, showing a lot more aggressiveness now after making 0 trips to the line in the first quarter.
Maladone's checked in for Charlotte. And so he makes both from the line.
I love it. In attack mode. Drawing foul calls this quarter and getting to the free throw line.
Pass to Washington. No good. And it's Dallas the other way.
Oh, gritty defense. Protecting the rim at all costs against a guy who has all sorts of ways to finish.
Doncic outside. And count that. 2 points and a chance for one more at the line.
What an aggressive mindset in this period. He's starting to take over.
The free throw off from Doncic.
Well, watching Luka Doncic, you see someone who has got extraordinary feel for the game of basketball. Knows when to score it, knows when to pass it. His vision and his big-time shot-making are all incredible.
From deep, Hayward. The Mavericks have gotten 6 of 9 attempts to go in the second. Looking good.
Boy, guys, with that appearance in the Western Conference Finals, it certainly feels like the Dallas Mavericks took a huge step forward. They played to their strengths. Obviously, the axis is Luka Doncic and his incredible skill set.
Up top, Hayward, guarded by Doncic. Hayward's shot is off.
What a brutal night for this guy, and it is having a ripple effect throughout the team. This is tough.
And Doncic launches from deep. Dallas again missing. Right. It almost seems like last year we were seeing the team Dallas had been waiting for, Doris.
It seems, B.A., they finally figured out what pieces need to be fit around Luka Doncic. Obviously, you need high-caliber shooting across positions. The one thing I think they need to continue thinking about is that rim protector and vertical threat.
Defensively, you can't afford to get stuck on the pick.
You know exactly what that takes. It takes energy, it takes activity, it takes intensity.
And Doncic launches from deep. Oh, he airballs the triple. That one was way off. Pass to Mykhailiuk. Washington inside. Kleba on him. And he's headed to the line for two. He gets the whistle there. And not many teams have as solid a piece to build around as the Hornets do with LaMelo Ball.
LaMelo clearly is a guy who has incredible confidence, incredible vision and passing ability. When you look at his ability to make the game easy for the players around him, and sometimes in transition, to make those elite athletes look incredibly special, he is a guy that you would enjoy playing with.
That free throw, no good. We've seen fans removed for inappropriate comments to players. Doris, where do you draw the line between heckling and being inappropriate?
I think one way I look at this, Brian, is if I were face-to-face with somebody, what would I be comfortable saying? I think we should always err on the side of caution. It's okay to heckle and have some fun and sort of give your team support, but I think if we ultimately keep respect foremost in our minds, we'll be okay.
Wood outside. On target from range. Wood's got 14.
Neal Akina may not be the prototypical lead guard, but he puts it on time and on target right there.
Here's Maladon. He's got 5. Good work there as it goes. Maladon's got 4 points in the quarter.
They didn't do themselves any favors with their shooting in the first quarter, but they're starting to pick it up now.
Here's Neal Akina. In his last outing, 8 points for him. Irving, no good.
This has not been a good period for this guy. Out of sync, not letting the game come to him. He's got to settle down and make shots.
Washington outside. Counted from distance. He's got 13.
I'll tell you, what a night. He has been efficient. He's been strong. Unfortunately, they're still fighting an uphill battle.
Pass to Irving. Wood with it. Williams defending. And Wood with the basket on the assist from Irving.
I am simply blown away by his accuracy. He has made every shot, and what's most important, his team is winning.
Williams, a screen on Irving, to the middle. And Williams punches it home.
He put a little flair on that one.
Yes, he did. Man, he's a strong finisher, huh? Pass to Neal Akina. Here's Wood. Bullock. Good.
And the defense has no one to blame but themselves. I mean, they just let him get right to the rim.
To me, this has simply stated been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
Here's Maladon. Three-pointer. Rebounded by Green. And for the Mavericks, they're shooting an amazing 61%. Looking confident. The three from Wood. Can't hit that one.
He didn't make them pay for that weak defense, but they just can't rely on him to miss those kind of shots.
The three from Washington. It doesn't go for him. Now Dallas takes it the other way. That'll be just the second road game of 5 in a row. On the wing, Green. And it goes out of bounds. That one off Green. Here's a look at what's coming up for the Charlotte Hornets. On Tuesday, they kick off a road trip at Oklahoma City, where they'll take on the Thunder. Then on Friday, they'll be matching up with Andre Drummond and the Chicago Bulls. Charlotte's gone 2 of 5 from distance here in the second quarter. Washington a screen. Here's Maladon. It's rebounded by Ntilikina.
And their physical dominance has been on display. A 10-rebound advantage is a good indicator of how this game has gone.
Out of bounds. It'll be Hornets ball. Thor, he's checked in for Mykhailiuk. Powell, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Hardy comes in for Irving. Charlotte is shooting about 41%. Here's McGowan's. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Here's Maladon. And it falls for him. He's now 4 of 7 from the field.
Scoring well this quarter. Picking up steam as he goes.
Here's Ntilikina. Pass to Hardy. Takes a three. Here's Wood. Oh, three chances on that possession, but they just can't find a way to score. Washington inside, guarded by Wood. Here's Maladon. Here's McGowan's. Drops in the three.
They've got some ground to make up, and shooting the three ball more consistently, like they are now, should help them do it.
Wood outside. The baseline J. It's rebounded by Charlotte. Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Well, the Mavericks this season trying to build the title contender around Luka Doncic, but not a lot of luxury tax wiggle room. Luka said, quote, "I trust them. Whatever move they make, I have great teammates and we're playing great basketball." Brian?
Well, no one wants to see Luka in the playoffs, Allie. Thanks for that.
The rebounding numbers make it obvious why they're in front.
Well, they've absolutely dominated that category in this one, and it's reflected in the score.
Green for three. The shot, no good. So the Hornets will take it the other way. Pass to Maladon. Here's Thor. This one for three. It's rebounded by Ntilikina. For three, Hardy nails it from beyond the arc. Hardy's got 6 points.
And just not letting up at all. I mean, you have to love this approach. You want to get the ball to the guys who make plays.
One thing we've learned in the NBA, the game is never over. So you've got to continue to score, continue to build your lead.
Dallas shooting a solid 53% from the floor. From downtown. Here's Wood, and he goes in for the dunk.
Oh my, what a display of effort.
That's his bread and butter, right? Chasing down the boards.
What about the decisive finish? Great timing, tremendous force.
Oh, what a performance by Luka Doncic. He has been the story for the Mavericks. He's been doing damage on the offensive end all night. 28 points in this one. More 2K action in just a moment.
Welcome, everybody. Let's get right to it. It's been nothing short of a tremendous challenge for the Charlotte Hornets.
I know teams love to rely on the three these days, but you got to know when to get away from it. They didn't, at least throughout the first half. Hopefully, they're making the adjustments, but sometimes teams just get stubborn.
And let's focus now on the two opposing guys who were battling in the first half. There were sparks out there.
Two guys clearly battling for the spot, both putting on a show. You just hope it doesn't become an all-hero ball.
Yeah, it's the scoreboard that decides the real winner in the end. That's pretty profound on my part, don't you think?
Yes, it does.
Thanks for joining us. Time to head back over to the third quarter with Brian Anderson.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Boy, really an incredible game here from Luka Doncic.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled, talented, and thus far, unstoppable.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the rout that it's threatening to be. At the forward spots, Hayward and Washington. Booknight out there with Sviatoslav Mykhailiuk. And it's Richards in at the center position, locking down the middle. That's the five to begin the second half for Steve Clifford. And that one's good. Irving.
Yeah, that's just the master of understanding pick and roll and how to develop a quality shot. Such a dangerous guy in those sets. What fascinates me about Kyrie Irving, clearly he is one of the most skilled guards to ever play. Ask his counterparts, other NBA players, who their favorite basketball player is, who the most complete player is. The answer will be Kyrie Irving.
Pass to Bullock. The three is up. The shot is good. Doncic making the play. Doncic has got his fourth assist with that last one. And for the Hornets, they're shooting just under 40% from the field. Here's Booknight. Now here's Washington. Gets it. He's 6-for-10 and looking confident out there. And again, about Kyrie Irving. We really are witnessing one of the best point guards to play the game, Doris.
B.A., one of the best scoring guards we have ever seen. His handle is elite. It gives you some sense of how much the position has evolved. Point guards almost must score as much as they facilitate.
Washington, a screen on Irving. Mykhailiuk. No good from outside. Dallas has gone 1-of-2 shooting from the perimeter since halftime. Now here's Irving. 7 points in the game. Doncic outside. Shoots over Hayward. Oh, Hayward with some nice D.
More often than not, he'll cash it in from that area. The defense might have done just enough to bother him.
Pass to Richards. Hayward with it. Three-pointer, Booknight. Kyrie Irving clears the rebound.
Since halftime, they've missed three of their first four shots. Still trying to get their legs under them.
Second half of play here with just under 2.5 minutes passed. A nice shot by Doncic.
Well, you love that they've been able to rely on him time and time again. You love the effort here late.
Pass to Hayward. The Mavericks pull it in. Bullock's got 5 rebounds in the game.
Halftime didn't do them any favors offensively. They've missed 4 of their last 5 shots.
Back to Kleba. Here's Powell. Shot clock at 6. Pass to Bullock. There's the triple. The shot is good. Doncic making the play. Doncic has got his 5th assist in this one.
They've been pretty lax with their perimeter defense, giving up a lot of 3-pointers.
Now Hayward. To the paint. Here's Washington. Right through the D for the layup. Washington's got 17.
And with Gordon Hayward, that well-rounded game, you will get a little bit of everything. Pretty pass there.
Doncic finds Irving. 3-pointer, no good.
Not himself from range right now, but the only way out of this funk is to keep trying.
Pass to Hayward. Washington with the ball. Over Irving. Washington's shot is good. Washington's got 19 points.
Well, he's been shooting it so well because he's been so active, moving and working to get high percentage shots.
Kleba outside. The steal. Here's Mykhailiuk. Here's Booknight. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul and he'll take 2 free throws now. It goes on Kyrie Irving. And let's take a moment to get your take, guys, on the scoring so far for the Mavericks.
What a performance from Beyond the Arc in this game. They stuck to their guns, and it's paid off all game.
Well, I also noticed, guys, how much they moved the ball in this one. Selfless, willing to pass the ball to a teammate with a better look.
And And he makes a first.
When you consider James Bouknight selected overall number 11 back in 2021, and I think that had a lot to do with his potential more than what he brought to the table initially.
Smith, he's checked in for Charlotte. And Dallas also making a switch. Holiday's checked in for Bullock. No good on the second, so he hits one of two. And it was no surprise that Bouknight went relatively early in the draft, Doris.
Well, I think he's got a lot of talent, obviously. He's got a lot of confidence. He stands 6'5", so this is all about player development, especially from a scoring standpoint.
Charlotte has got nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Pass to Richards. Here's Hayward. Three-pointer. The Mavericks pull it in. Kleba's got four rebounds now. Now Irving. He's got seven. Doncic on the wing, covered by Smith. Kleba outside. The three ball. That one falls. Great setup by Doncic. Doncic has got his sixth assist of the night.
In today's game, you can never afford to get beat in the three-point battle.
Here's Richards. Pass to Mykhailiuk. Richards with a screen. Inside. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Richards has got his second bucket of the night.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Here's Doncic. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Doncic. All right, let's use this time to check out the teams with the most steals last year. Charlotte in fifth.
And this is a team that takes great pride in being aggressive on the defensive end. They take good risk and know when to go after opportunities for steals.
Kleba against Hayward. Puts up a three. And Kyrie Irving clears the rebound. Irving's got four rebounds in the game.
It's been an ugly quarter for him. Trying to shoot his way out of it. Might be time to work on the playmaking skills. That's a move you won't see many guys make. Impressive stuff.
13 feet out. And misses it off the right side of the rim. Dallas has gotten 3 of 6 threes to fall in the third quarter. Kleba passes to Irving. For three. Hornets with the rebound.
Boy, a forgettable night for him. But thankfully, his teammates have played well overall.
Pass to Richards. Now Smith. Here's Richards. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line. That one on Doncic.
You know, there was a time years ago when the Mavericks were one of the NBA's shakiest teams. Now they're one of its proudest franchises.
And he knocks down the first one. And you can attribute the Mavs' rise to stable ownership and some very savvy front office moves.
Yeah, so true, B.A. They've made some great decisions in the draft, for sure. They've been able to find cornerstone players and build solid rosters around them.
The Mavericks making a switch here. Woods checked in for Kleba. Green comes in for Holiday. Hardy, he's checked in for Irving. And it's Ntilikina in for Luka Doncic. Here's Ntilikina. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Wood. Another shot. And Powell with the lay-in.
Well, this is where Dwight Powell is in his element. All of those physical abilities coming to bear on the interior. Nicely done.
Picked by Smith. Pass to Thor. Smith outside. Just five to shoot. Williams with the screen. Smith passes to Williams. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
The officials were right on top of that one.
free throw drops for Williams. And this Mavericks team, Grant, they are loaded up on shooters who can hurt you from outside.
And that's the way they should be built. Force teams to spread out and give Luka space. And when the Mavs get hot from outside, they are dangerous.
The Hornets making a switch here. Maladone's checked in. And Williams drops them both.
And they've been playing with much greater physicality this half. Getting themselves to the free throw line is a must.
There's a screen. Wood outside. Here's the three. Good. 8 buckets in 12 attempts.
They are unconscious from outside. And so far, the defense has had no answer.
Well, that's the whole point, isn't it? If you space the floor well enough, it's almost impossible for the defense to account for everyone.
Pass to Thor. Here's Maladon. 9 points in the game. Hey, now 5 for 8, shooting a pretty good percentage right now.
Well, use the pick and going right to the cup. I love the aggressiveness.
And he drives in. Nilakina gets the bucket.
This is critical to Nilakina's development. Nice drive right there.
Here's Smith. It's rebounded by Nilakina.
Well, they get it to the high percentage area, and then it all goes wrong from there.
Let's it go. It's rebounded by Charlotte.
All alone from mid-range. They know he won't miss many of those.
Pass to Smith. To the middle. And stolen by Wood. Here's Hardy. He's got 6. Here's Wood, covered by Smith. Shoots a fadeaway. And it's Thor with a rebound. Well, the Hornets shooting a disappointing 38%. Smith outside. Pass to Thor. Fires the 3. Knocks down the triple.
And this is what you want from Dennis Smith Jr. He has to find the open man and deliver it on time and on target.
Here's Hardy. Beyond the arc. Sends it home from three-point land. Hardy's gotten his 3rd basket of the night.
That's how you up the ante. Come right back at him.
And you would expect nothing less from these two, taking pride and making plays.
Here's McGowan's. First one falls. And he makes both free throws. And for the Mavericks, they're shooting an excellent rate of 56% in the 3rd quarter. So it's the Mavericks now. Here's Hardy. 9 points in the game. Launches a 3. The shot won't fall. And here's Smith. Pass to Williams. Here's Maladon. Back to Williams. And he gets that one. Williams has gotten four this quarter. And for the Mavericks, they're shooting around 53%, a nice number. Here's Ntilikina, covered by Smith. And there's the call on Dennis Smith. That'll be foul number five on him. Bullock, he's checked in for the Mavericks. Here's Ntilikina, covered by Smith. Ntilikina gets the bucket. He's got five.
Well, this is what they want from Ntilikina. Come with an aggressive attitude and be confident in your three-point shot.
Williams with the screen. Smith passes to Williams. Now here's Smith, guarded by Wood. Goes up and lays it in, nice and easy. Smith's got 7 points in the game.
Well, we see a lot of emphasis on three-point shooting nowadays, but you'll take that look right there any night of the week.
Pass to Ntilikina. To the inside. Yes! And the foul! Smith. And so he's picked up his final foul, and he'll sit the rest of this one out. And the Hornets making a change here. Washington's checked in. The free throw off from Wood. For Charlotte, they've gone 50% from the field in the third quarter. 8 of 16. Washington outside. And the Hornets, another three.
Well, after netting one in the first half, that's the second deep ball to go down for this guy.
Pass to Ntilikina. Wood against Williams. Here's Ntilikina. He's got five. Offline from the top of the key. Here's McGowan's. Shoots over Hardy. And it's Charlotte with another. And so it's Dallas firmly in control with an impressive 28-point lead as the quarter ends. It hasn't taken them too many shots to get their points. They're winning with efficiency. And more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way right after this. All right, let's listen in. Head coach Jason Kidd is mic'd up.
We got some great looks. Defensively, we're getting stops too.
And Jason Kidd, happy with the way his team is performing, hoping they can maintain momentum.
Well, they're working together, both ends of the floor, and doing a great job of playing at their pace.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works, or if it's more of the same for the first three quarters. On the court right now for Dallas, Davis Bertans is out there. JaVale McGee, then there's Justin Holiday, then it's Hardy, and it's Pinson in at the three, the small forward. Pass to McGee. Here's Hardy. And he lobs it up to the rim! Oh, and makes it with the kiss.
Well, we talk about playing to your size. A 6'10", Davis Bertans got to make that look easy.
And as the NBA becomes an increasingly global game, Grant, there's a component of international relations that has to come into it. What are your thoughts about this?
Well, it can be tricky. I mean, it's a challenge. You have to respect people's cultures and way of doing business. But yes, the game, I believe, also can play a role in bringing cultures and different countries together over the love of the game of basketball.
And stolen by Holiday, and they're running. Pass to Penson. Let's go with a three. He can't get that one to fall. Now Charlotte takes it the other way. Here's Booknight. And here's Jones. Down low. Ooh, anticipated the pass. It's a turnover. Outside Holiday. They set the screen. Bertans against Jones. Six on the shot clock. Dallas needs to get off a shot. Launches it. Jones grabs the board. Charlotte has gone one of two from deep in this quarter. Here's Booknight. Pass to McGowans. Jones sets a screen. Baseline jumper. And once again, off the mark by Charlotte. The Mavericks have gotten half of their attempts to fall in the fourth. Two for four now. Back to Holiday. Fires from deep. Pure from three-point range. Holiday's gotten himself on the board with a three there.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
Here's McGowans. He's covered by Holiday. Here's Booknight. Charlotte again missing. And Dallas with possession. They've gone on an 8-0 run. Basket counts.
Such confidence as a passer. He hits guys in stride and makes it look easy.
For Charlotte, they've gone 1-4 since the fourth quarter began. Here's Booknight. There's a screen. Buries it from three.
Well, the defense daring him to shoot, and he makes them pay for their disrespect.
Here's Hardy. Well, Grant, this is the business you and I are in. NBA has a couple of years with existing TV partners. How much are we going to see things change with the next deal, you think?
Oh, BA, this is interesting as this continues to evolve. I think as people's viewing habits have changed in the last 10 to 15 years, I think live sports and the NBA game is still something fans love to see in real time. I think also the fact that we can also attract a larger audience is exciting. I don't know how it'll all play out, but I know it'll be fun to follow and watch as we go.
Ooh, a little luck that time as it drops.
Willing passers, unselfish play. You have to appreciate this kind of offense.
Out to the right wing. Here's Thor. From deep. And the Hornets, another three.
Listen, even average three-point shooters are going to make that shot. Defense must be better.
Now here's Holiday. Pass to Hardy. Let's go with a three. Washington grabs the miss. Washington's got his seventh rebound here tonight. Here's Thor. Washington, a screen on McGee. Here's Booknight. And another basket for Charlotte.
Not the most effective pick, but he salvages the play with a terrific move.
Dallas has gone 3 of 6 from downtown so far in the fourth. Holiday with the ball. Here's Penson. Offline with a three.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
Here's Booknight. The shot off that time. The Mavericks have gotten 6 of 10 attempts to drop in the fourth quarter. Pass to Holiday. Doris, in the NBA, more attention is being paid to mental health more than ever before. And players are taking the lead in raising awareness.
I love that, Brian, because it's such an important issue. Performing between the lines of an NBA floor requires basketball skill, but it also requires mental health and strength. And a lot of players, Kevin Love in particular, have been so brave. Credit to the NBA for addressing it and being out front. I know he's got to be frustrated right now, but the team is fighting from behind. He's got to stay with it.
Here's Hardy. Outside Holiday, launches a three. That shot is off. Pass to McGowan's. Jones with a screen on Holiday. Here's Booknight. From 12 feet, hauled in by McGee.
He's trying to force his way into a rhythm, but that's not helping the team.
Now here's Holiday. Oh, swiped away. Here's McGowan's. Pass to Booknight. To the left side wing. Just five on the clock. From behind the arc. Mavericks with a rebound. McGee's got four rebounds in the game. Here's Pinson. Now Holiday. Pass to Pinson. McGee a screen. Lets a three fly. Pinson, good.
Their defense has to do a better job of smothering those shooters.
Charlotte has gone 3 of 6 from downtown so far in the fourth. To the wing on the left. Here's McGowan's. He's covered by Holiday. Back to Washington. To stop the drought! And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. McGee's got 5 rebounds tonight. Pass to Holiday. Well, Grant, the NBA has led the way when it comes to diversity and representation in high-level jobs. Grant, what are your thoughts on it?
Yeah, B.A., I love this. I mean, the NBA really, truly has been a leader when it comes to this. Whether it's coaches, front office, in the league office in New York, living and embodying the spirit of diversity and inclusion is what the NBA is all about. It's fun to be a part of.
The NBA, where everyone is welcome. Pass to Bertans. Second shot opportunity, and the bucket is good from McGee in deep.
And attacking a somewhat helpless defense right now. Just a relentless effort.
Well, you love that there's no let-up in how they're playing. They want to dominate every aspect, including second-chance points. Well, after hitting one triple in the first half, it's been all radio silence since.
Good on the shot. McGee's got 6 in the quarter. And for the Hornets, they're shooting at 31% here in this fourth quarter. Pass to Thor from downtown. Hits the trifecta.
Yeah, he's in his bag from beyond the arc right now. You see his confidence.
And I think the defender knows once he gets cooking, look out. The bucket looks awfully big to him right now.
Holiday finds Bertans. Holiday with the ball. Here's Hardy. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws. PJ Washington picks one up, and Doris, Commissioner Silver has expressed a desire to ensure star players participate in a full complement of games. What's the answer here?
I think, BA, a couple things come to mind. There's been a long discussion about whether you can shorten the regular season. That obviously impacts revenue generated, so I'm not sure you'd go there. The league could also structure contracts to incentivize games played.
First one falls for him. Both teams will make substitutions. Good on both. There's a minute 40 left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Williams. And here is Hayward. Williams, a screen on Kleba. Here's Thor. That one's good, and it's Hayward with the setup.
And what a complete performance we saw from them. A dominant win in every way for the Mavericks.
One area where they set themselves apart today, their aggressiveness in getting steals.
It really hindered their opponent all game long. And of course, it helped spark their own offense.
And so this win marks their first victory of the new year.
And I'm sure they're happy to get even for what happened the last time these teams met.
And one player just stole the show tonight, doing everything for his team. A monster night for Luka Doncic.
We saw him get a lot of touches tonight, and he wasted very few of them. Really made himself the backbone of their offense.
I'll tell you, this has not been his game, and he's making it worse with shot selection like that.
There's 42 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And here's Holiday. Pass to Bullock. Takes a 13-footer. Here's Hardy. Buries it down low.
And they came in here with some attitude, and it brought out their best play.
And I couldn't agree more. What makes it that much more impressive, they're doing it on the road.
Williams, a screen on Kleba. Hayward, the pass to Williams. Here's Booknight. He's covered by Holiday. Over to the left wing. Maladon for three. Wood grabs the board. Now here's Holiday. And so it's the Mavericks taking care of business in this one. To walk into enemy territory and deliver a performance like that, that says a lot about this squad.
They really came in looking confident and didn't let anything shake them. This is what a dominant team looks like.
And now let's check in with Allie LaForce with the player of the game. Allie.
Kyrie, what does it mean for this team getting the production off the bench that we saw tonight?
It's big time. You know, when you're a basketball player and you're able to make the right plays and play at a high intensity level and really come out and make an impact on the game, no matter if you're starting or coming off the bench, we've seen special guys do that. I'm glad we came out and handled business.
Thanks, Allie. Great interview once again. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Allie LaForce, Doris Burke, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson alongside our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for watching. So long, everyone. Yeah.